Hey everybody, and welcome back to 7-Minute AE Tutorials, where you learn AE tips, tricks, and shortcuts all within 7 minutes. No BS, just AE. Okay, so what I want to show you guys this week is a circle transition using shape layers. We're going to focus primarily on trim paths. Okay, so let's right-click, add a shape layer. You want to add our first group. I'm going to call this color 1. Okay, and then within the color 1 group, we want to add an ellipse, add a stroke, and add trim paths. Now, what trim paths allows you to do is to animate strokes off and on. And I say strokes for a reason, and I'll show you why. Go ahead and add trim paths. And within trim paths, we have the start, end, and offset. We're going to focus on start and end. So let's make this stroke bigger so you can see it better. So as you kind of start to play with these percentages, you can see how you can keyframe these off and on. Now watch, if you don't use a stroke, but instead use a fill, what you end up getting is this weird kind of animation where you just, you know, that's not at all what we want. So what we want to do, use a stroke, take off the fill. Okay, so let's change this stroke to something like a red. What's really important with what I'm going to show you guys today is this. Your ellipse path size needs to be the same size as your stroke width. So we're going to do 200. So 200 ellipse path, 200 stroke. And the reason why is this. If your stroke size is smaller than your ellipse size, you get this circle in the middle, this open in the middle. Also, if the stroke is larger than the size, you get this deforming right here. So we don't want that. So let's make this 200 again. So the way we want to animate this on, set both of these to 0. Put a keyframe for end, go forward 15 frames, go up to 100, then set a keyframe for start at the same frame as your end, and go forward to a second, and animate that up to 100. So this is what we have. So just a simple animate on, animate off. Let's highlight these, hit F9 to make Bezier keyframes. There we go. With our marker right here at the 15 second mark, let's duplicate color 1, so Control D. All right, now let's change the color to like a blue. Now as you can see, you can't see it right now because it's the same size as color 2. So let's go down and make this say 350. And again, we want to make our stroke the same size, so 350. Let's duplicate color 1 again. Again, go to the bottom layer. Let's change this color to something like a green, maybe. Let's make this size 500, stroke size 500. Control D again. Make this 650, stroke size 650. Let's change this color, kind of orange. There we go. Go back to color 1, Control D. Let's change this color to darker orange. Now we want to make this 850, make the stroke 850, and we'll duplicate it one more time, and let's make this 1200 and the stroke size 1200. Okay, so for this last color, what you can do is you can change the color to whatever background color you want this to transition onto, and I'll show you what I mean by that in just a second. So what we have here is this. Okay, so let's go up to our shape layer, hit U to bring up our keyframes, and we want to offset each group by 3 frames. So if you hit page down 3 times, 1, 2, 3, and grab your second group here, pull it over. Just do this for every group, 1, 2, 3. So this is what we have right here. What I was saying before, like if you want this to animate onto a color you're going to use for your next comp, just take off these start keyframes here on the last color. So what you're going to end up having is this. So say you wanted some text to animate in. Now again, like I mentioned last week, use this move anchor point to center the anchor point of your text, and then you want to align it like that to the middle. Go to about like a second and 6 frames. If you hit your open bracket, it brings over your layer to wherever your marker is. So wherever you put your marker, hit left bracket. Let's go ahead and animate this in. Make that an easy end by hitting Shift F9. Let's go to our graph editor, pull this keyframe over. If you hold down Control and press a keyframe, it makes it a linear keyframe. So let's set it for this. Now, whenever you have transitions like this, it's really important to enable your motion blur here. It looks a lot better. There you go. Okay, so now if you want to use this transition to go from one scene to the next, but you don't want to use this as a background, what you do is simply go back down to your last layer, put a start keyframe at the same spot as your last end keyframe, hit F9 to make it Bezier, go forward 15 frames, and crank it up to 100. Animates on, animates off. As I've mentioned before, you can save this as a preset, and the way you do that, highlight all of your layers, animation, save animation preset, and again, it comes to your documents folder, Adobe, whatever version you're using, user presets. You see this folder structure I have here is reflected in our project file over here. So we're gonna go into transitions, and let's just name this circle transition 2, hit save, get rid of our contents. Let's go open up our animation presets, user presets. We have transitions, so let's grab circle transition 2. And remember, you want to put your marker wherever you want your animation to begin, because wherever you drop in this preset is going to be where the first keyframe goes. So let's bring it into here, hit U to look at our keyframes, and there it is. Trim Pass is a very powerful way of animating shape layer strokes. This is just the tip of the iceberg. There are so many ways that you can use this to create very cool transitions and icons. For example, these were all created using shape layers, and they were animated primarily using trim paths. I'll put a link to this project file along with the preset we just created in the comments below. I hope this helped you out. This is a new channel, and I'd love to do a lot more of these. So please subscribe, like, share, and comment. Let me know in the comments if there's anything you'd like to see. Thanks, everybody, and I'll see you next time.